Good evening. My name is Major Angela Berth. I'm with the Air Force. I'm currently assigned to the Joint Staff. And I'm here tonight to present you a special recipe for how to motivate tacit knowledge and information sharing. Now, why do we want to do that? Many of you, like me in this room, are from large hierarchical organizations, and you don't know what the guy three cubicles down knows or is an expert at, let alone the guy in the next division. All right? So that's the kind of the big recipe, why do we want to do this sort of thing? So I'm going to present you today with a special recipe to do that. And here's the key ingredients to make all that happen, and I want you to consider what is happening here in this very special blend of people, process, and technology, and that's what those Venn diagram represents. People, the domains of people, process, and technology. And that special place in the middle there, that's a targeted transformation, change in our organizational behavior. We need Wickonomics. We need cultural change. And well, you can't just, go in and write a policy that says my culture's changed. No,
why not?
But we can inflict some organizational behavior, and that's what we're going to target, to get to culture change. And of course, then there's an extra special secret sauce. Give that on to you in a little bit here. All right. So, Wickonomic world. This is the body of literature, field of practice, as it were, for this whole area that gives us the capability of doing all of this today. And a couple of my recommended books are up here too, by the way. We Are Smarter Than Me. In my world, I call that an army field manual. That means it's written by the we, and I am in the we. And it's written by the we, and it's at 10th, 11th grade level. A lot of pictures, very high level, very easy to understand. If you want to go deeper, get into the book Wickonomics, and you really start to understand how the companies of the world, corporations of the world, are applying Wickonomics, this new principle called Wickonomics. And you're going, what the heck is Wickonomics? All right, formally defined as the art and science of peer production. You go, great! What's that? Well, that is how we take collaboration and have developed a new value creation method. So that's what art and science of peer production and how we apply the collaborative we against our problem sets. So, you see many companies, the Amazons, the eBays, they're all building new methods that include trust and reciprocity within those processes and those methods for you as a consumer to establish a one-time relationship with someone in Sri Lanka. Now, you'll never meet that person, but they have a market reputation that's recorded by a star rating, a 4.5 rating, whatever you want to call it. And so how do we take that? And by the way, I'm just trying to tear down the walls within an organization. I'm not even doing the true we and these ideas of innocenter.com. This is Procter & Gamble is taking huge advantage of this. They're putting out their R&D problems to the world and saying, you bring me a solution, there's $500,000 or $1 million for you. They don't know whose the solution is going to come from. Now, I want to take that principle and just put it inside the Joint Staff first. Just tear down those, because we're not always in the right place in the Joint Staff. We don't necessarily know who all knows what their past assignments are. We all have individual subject matter expertise. And what I'm submitting to you is that over our entire adult careers, we develop various subject matter expertise, and I can be a four-star, five-star kind of person in this wiki world, and a half-star sort of person in this applied algebra world, and other things. But that my performance can indicate that, and my contributions can indicate that. So I'm sure you're all familiar with eBay, Amazon. Yeah? You buy that five or four and a half star thing over the two star thing, right? So we're applying those kind of principles. All right. So here's the stimulate culture change one. As I said earlier, we can really only stimulate changes in organizational behavior, and hopefully they translate and become organizational culture changes. Here's some of the things in this particular applied example that we need to do. We need to get information sharing outside of structural hierarchies. Now, I presented this idea recently, last Friday, to the vice chairman. And he gave me the head nod, we're going to develop this. And he goes, great ideas, I'm plagiarizing the heck out of your work.
Cool, sir. Go ahead.
But he says, we're not introducing it to the staff for at least 4 months. 4 months. He said, why? And he said, people will lose their jobs today for participating like this. Why? Because what I'm going to show you in a little bit, people are meeting the needs of other hierarchies within the joint staff, mind you, but still, somebody else. That's a huge culture change in the joint staff. And people literally will lose their jobs. So you can't underestimate this. So we gotta stimulate the cultural change. So I bring the method, I tell you how, but it still takes, I can't wait to see what he's gonna do, because he said, no, don't worry, 4 months, that won't happen. I said, can't wait, stand by. All right, so some of the things I say, you gotta recognize that kind of behavior. And you got to reward subject matter experts for being as they are. A lot of academics say, I'm not going to share. In my mind. Well, we've got to, in a market kind of way, incentivize that behavior to motivate that behavior. And what did I say? Trust reciprocity. How do I know what this Doug guy? Can he answer my problems with regard to this? He just responded. He just gave me an answer. Should I accept it? I don't know. What does this market performance say? So we're going to establish some different things. All right, there's the secret sauce. Simple enough. What's in it for me? Or if you're trying to get information sharing going between organizations, countries, some other people presented some country problems. What's in it for my country? Why should I share it with you? Well, you can put out the carrot. You can say, you can have some of mine. Give up some of yours, I'll give you some of mine. What's in it for me? You gotta have organizational stimuli to buy in. I already kind of pretty much talked about that.